This is Chris. I know it's been a while. I'm sorry about that. I am going to give some life updates as well as some stitching updates, and I'm going to take care of those things first. I've been away for a little while. I have had what I have been calling the plague since about the beginning of March. I had what I believe to be a cold, a viral infection, and you know, it was a week and it got better. And a few days later, it seemed like I was sick again. And it's like, well, that's weird. You can't catch the same cold twice. I don't know if people know that. Once you've had a virus, you've built an immunity up to it, and you can't, under most circumstances, get it again. And so that cold was a little bit worse than the first one. And it was about a week, and I felt better for a few days. And then this time around, the symptomology was different. I thought perhaps it was a sinus infection this time around. Excuse me, I'm not going to edit that out probably, but I will be coughing and sniffling a little bit. Sorry about that. But I had the sinus drainage and sore throat and coughing constantly. And I had no voice, which prevented me from filming last week, but I kept waiting to feel better, and I finally am at that spot. We also had a death in the, I'm going to say in the family, my parents' best friends. My father grew up with the father. My mother grew up with the mother. Their daughter is my age. We were, at the beginning of our lifetimes, forced to be friends when we didn't really want to be. But now we are very close. And they were always like my second set of parents. And Raymond had been very, very ill for a very long time. And then a little over a year ago, he was diagnosed with cancer and was only given, oh, I think a couple of months to live. But he lingered for well over a year. And it was terrible and horrible. And he went into hospice care right after I shot my last video, probably. And God bless him, it took him a long time to pass, and it was rough on all of us. And then I got sick right after that, so I wasn't even able to attend the funeral, which sucked. But I mean, it's not like he was young. It wasn't tragic. It was just painful to those of us who loved him. So it was actually a blessing when he did pass, because he was so ill. But that kind of zapped my stitchy bug, along with not feeling well myself. Anyway, that's why I didn't get a lot of stitching done, and that's why I didn't post an update. I'm going to shoot my video a bit backwards this time around. I'm going to do haul first, because it's my video and I feel like it. So if you don't like haul, move forward, and you'll probably see a break. And it'll be pretty obvious when I have switched to my WIP update from my haul. There's a lot, because there's a lot of shit going on, and I was emotional, and I bought a lot of stuff. That's how it goes. So, got some things from Ship's Manor. I joined the Halloween sale. I've joined all of Eric's sales. I haven't started any of them, but I joined them all. I'm going to stitch them, and I'm probably, we'll talk about that. But anyway, this is for the Halloween, this is the floss for the Halloween sale. I already have fabric that I have picked out. That's a dark blue from Steph, I believe, that I will probably use, or else I'll use the NYX from Leslie. We'll see how it looks when I see it. But anyway, Garrett showed this in his last video, so I'm not going to show it again. This is my floss of the month from Jidru Designs, which I had dropped out of, but she just keeps sending me invoices and I keep paying them, so I'm still getting them. And I got some needle minders from Nifty Needle Nannies, a cute little Mardi Gras fleur de lis. I don't remember ordering this. She may have thrown that in for free. A peacock feather and Jack and Sally. There are two more. I don't know where they are right now. I don't remember what they are either. There's two more, though. This is the fabric from Eric from Ship's Manor for the Mystery Town stitch along. Should this be higher, maybe? Let me see. Hold on one sec, guys. Is that better? That might be better. Anyway, this is the fabric for that. I'm in love with this fabric. I'm probably going to order this for more things that I want to look like they're out in the sky. It's really nice linen. It feels nice. This is a 32 count Belfast in cloud shapes from Ship's Manor. This video is going to be a mess. You know, whatever. It just is. And I got my fabric of the month for, I guess this was February, from Gina. This is called Gina. Or no, not from Gina. What am I talking about? This is from Steph. Hand-dyed fabrics by Stephanie. It is called Gina. And it is a 22 count, what is that called? Cashel. Beautiful colors though. And it's showing up pretty true. But I love that. I'm not sure. I think I might know what I'm going to do with that. And then this was the March fabric of the month from Steph. And it is called Iris, which, funny story, so is Leslie's, also called Iris, but looks completely different. Also beautiful. I'm a sucker for sea colors, for blues and greens and purples. That is my absolute favorite. When I go to stitch something prim, I always find myself with very little thing choice to pick from. Trying to stitch from my fabric stash and not buy more, but then I do anyway. The next three are from a grab bag from Under the Sea Fabrics. I'm saying I'm a lot too. I'm sorry about that. This is NYX. This is 32 count. No, this is 36 count. Got them all in 36 count. Is that Edinburgh? Maybe? Yeah. Newcastle. One of those. This is called NYX. Absolutely beautiful. I may use this for Eric's Halloween stitch along. And I think that starts this month. I certainly won't be starting it, I don't believe, but... And the great thing is about the grab bags, I don't know if Leslie did that intentionally or not, but I didn't get any of the fabric that I already had from her, so that was cool. This, oops, sorry, hit my iPad. Apologize. This is called Christmas in Williamsburg. So, a much needed, oh, this is coming up much lighter than it really is. It's more of a deeper gold. And I don't know if you can hear the mower going out there. My neighbor has been out mowing all day long. And that's a whole story in itself, which I may or may not go into someday. This is really pretty. And then this is Buttercup, also 36 count. And that is showing up much lighter than it is. It is a more buttery, nice, creamy yellow. Really pretty. And then this was Leslie's March fabric of the month. And people have been showing this and is absolutely gorgeous. This is called Iris as well. This is in a 32 count Belfast. Just what I always order from Leslie. Absolutely beautiful. I might know what I'm going to do with that. Love it, love it. Okay, so this is a story. So this is... I ordered a yard of 36 count Mellow from 123 Stitch. It says Picture This Plus in Mellow. Guys, that is not Mellow. The description for Mellow is a... I'm not going to pull it up, but it says like a... And I've seen, I think Emily uses Mellow a lot. And it's like greens and grays and browns, if I'm not mistaken. And that's pretty close to what the description says. This looks like a creamsicle. Like, this is not Mellow. And because I wasn't feeling well, I just never got to the post office or to the UPS store to return it. I was coming home from work and I was going straight to bed and I was sleeping until I had to get up and go to work. That's all I did for like a month. And so the time ran out to return it to 123 Stitch. So I thought, I'll pull the old switcheroo. So with my last 123 Stitch order, I ordered another yard of it. And the price went up, but I didn't care because I was going to return this one when I got the right Mellow. It looks exactly the same. So I don't think it's a 1, 2, 3 stitch mislabel. I think it's a PTP, a picture of this plus mislabel. But it is clearly not mellow. But it looks like I have a yard of it, so I may be putting that up on Stash Unload. I don't know yet. I might use it. From Leslie, I got, of course, this little lady. I have no idea what she's called. I don't remember. What is she called? Andromeda, maybe? The heck's her name? Yeah, Andromeda. So I got her, and I got the... name's on there. The bead pack. If you buy these from Leslie, when she first puts them up, she gives you a 20% discount, which is awesome. Got an order from 123 Stitch. The picture of this plus fabric was part of it. Every time these go on sale, I buy them. The only one I have left to buy is the Easter Fairy. I haven't looked to see. Sorry, I'm getting a shadow every time I lean in. I haven't looked to see if that's on sale this week. I'm hoping it is, because that's the last one I have to buy. So I got Miss New Year's Eve Fairy. This is freaking fantastic. It's from the Cricut collection. It's called Sleepy Hollow. It's like, I've actually taken the pattern out and looked at it. I don't know if you have to stitch it. It almost looks like it could be a triptych. But that is fantastic. I don't know if it's new. I don't know if it's old. But I jumped on that. And it was on sale, too. So I usually only buy things that are on sale. Yeah. Just, oh my God. That could even go on that NYX, too. That just, like, that has to be stitched this year. That may be a mania start. I don't know. And then, excuse me. I need to get a drink. Sorry about that. Ginger ale. I'm like inhaling ginger ale these days. Diet ginger ale though. And then this is Glendon Place. This is tiramisu. So I got that. I got more things from Leslie when they came out. I got Solo Tua and her beads. And I got, what's this little lady's name? Tesoro Mio. And her bead pack. Because I love these little petites. They're adorable. I got my just cross stitch. The April edition. People have gone through it. I won't bother. Still looks like it's low. I'm going to raise it up just a smidge more. Bear with me, guys. I kind of knocked this down. I use my Lowry stamp, my phone. Okay. We're going to hold off on these Stitching Bits and Bobs order because I'm going to have a rant with that. And this is a combination of Stitching Bits and Bobs, no, Down Sunshine Lane and Stitch and Frog. And I can't remember which came from which, but they are both spectacular. It was my first time ordering from both. They had excellent service. They got things in very quickly and got them to me. Excellent communications. If there was any question, I know I posted in a group. It was for the Coffee Quaker Sal, because I ordered that too, but actually started it. So I'll show that to you in the whips. But in the Coffee Quaker Sal group, I posted, you know, I ordered from Stitch and Frog today. It's my first order. Does anybody know how long it takes? And she was like, oh, I shipped it this morning. I didn't realize she was in the group. So yeah, that was awesome. And you know, from Danielle, Stitcherista, that Down Sunshine Lane is awesome. They're just, no, I thought this wasn't recording. They're really good with their customer service as well. So believe it or not, I have most of the Bewitching Pixies, but I did not have, I can't remember her name. This is the one. Yeah, this is Gigi. I could not remember Gigi's name. Of course, I've been up since midnight-ish. No, I was up sooner than that. was up at like 10 and it is 10 p.m. It's 4:23 p.m. So it's way past time for my nap. But anyway, picked up Gigi. I didn't get the beads or anything. You know what? With all the beads I have from all these bead packs, I probably have them. Anyway, I got her and I picked this up. I saw Vanna had stitched that. Now I think I put it up too high. I'll pick this up. This is from Country Cottage Needleworks. It's called Stitching Time. I will probably change out those colors and use some of my hand dyes because I have a ton, but that is adorable. I got that from Jardin Privé. Before I actually saw, I think McKenna picked this up, but I got this too. I have friends who are engaged and they have two black cats, and when they get married, I somehow want to maybe work this into a wedding sampler. I don't know how I'm going to do it, but thinking this would be really good for them. So I had actually ordered this before I saw her video that she'd gotten it as well. And since their cats are black, I will just leave the kitty black. And then from Jardin Privé, I picked up the patchwork owls. That's just adorable. My mother loves owls, so at some point I will stitch that for her. Then, excuse me. Sorry about that. I really think at this point it's more allergies than anything else. When I went to my L&S, I had won a $25 gift certificate before Christmas. They had a box and you could enter your name, and it was for a gift certificate, and I won, which was awesome. And then I just never got in to pick up my gift certificate. So I finally got there, and as soon as I walked in, she said, "Hey, you won. Where have you been?" So I'm so sorry, I haven't been feeling well. So anyway, got my gift certificate and of course spent more than what I won, but that was okay. And she has a little punch card, like a rewards thing, like Starbucks. And after you spend so much money, then you get 10% off. So I had my gift certificate and I filled my card up. So I also got 10% off. So that was really nice. I got this hands-on designs. Oh, whale, which I just think is adorable and it's cute, and I can stitch that really quickly, but I like that a lot. And I got, oh, this love, 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 love. I saw it stitched, it was up on the wall. I think she had it finished as a pillow, and I don't remember having seen this. And I was talking to Heather, the Springfield stitcher, when I got home, and I said, "Look what I got." And she said, "Yeah, isn't that the one where there's the girl and the guy?" And I was like, "Oh crap. Tell me about the same thing twice." But it isn't. This is different. It's an older retired chart, and she just happened to have one that I found like tucked back in amongst everything else that she has. She has so much stuff, and the store is so tiny. It's too bad that she doesn't have more room. But I know rents in these places are really expensive. And it's in, sorry, everything's falling on me. I know rent's really expensive, especially she's kind of in one of the touristy areas in Lancaster County. So I know why the store's not bigger. I just wish that it could be. But yeah, I picked up Mermaid Cove, and she is just absolutely gorgeous. I've seen her stitched, and oh, I love her so much. So I'm glad I got her. And then I got Lizzie Kate. She's having a Lizzie Kate trunk show right now. And I am only one, but I am one. I cannot do everything, but I can do something. So that is just adorable. There's a bonus chart inside for the love one another. And the little charms are there as well. I also picked up Country Cottage Needleworks, Land of Liberty. And I was thinking that I was probably going to stitch this up for my aunt. Every time she comes here and she sees my cinnamon stars and my Home of a Needleworker, she wants to know when I'm going to stitch something for her. And I've already stitched something for her. It was just like a little weekender kit many, many years ago, probably about 15 or 20. But she wants something fancier. So, and she has kind of a patriotic ish dining room. So I think if I darken up the colors, it will match. I'll probably make the red and the blue darker, but I think she'll like that. So I picked that up for her. Don't know when I'll stitch it. And somehow I did not have Autumn U from Plum Street. How cute. I really want to stitch that guy. Everything I buy, I really want to stitch. It's not like I don't want to stitch these things. I do. But how adorable. I went to my LNS again yesterday. I bought, well, I'll show you what I bought after this. I went to Michael's to take advantage of some coupons, and this Dimensions Gold Kit Fall Fairy, which I've looked at, you know, I didn't want to pick it up, kind of gotten a little bit away from kits. I have a lot of kits. I still use them, but I wasn't really interested in starting this, but it was on sale for $12.99 maybe, and then there was a 15% off total coupon. So yeah, hell yeah, I bought her. And then their DMC was still priced at 39 cents. And I picked up 10 skeins of B5200 because B5200. And before that, I had stopped at my LNS to get my order from Nashville. You know what? I'm missing something. Oh well. What did I do with it? I don't know. I don't know. Maybe I'll grab it and maybe I'll just put it on my next video. But anyway, she had picked up Green Damsel from Ink Circles for me. And I also had her pick up Dragons of Sumatra because dragons. My boyfriend is very, very, he's a dragon guy. He loves them. I showed him this after I had her pick it up, you know, and he was like, oh, eh. So I thought he'd be thrilled with it, but he really wasn't. Anyway, another order somewhere. What did I do with it? It was from a new, no idea. It was from a new, to me, shop, and I ordered and it came super duper fast. I don't know. It's probably upstairs. And you know what? I'm not going upstairs. And the other thing I bought, she doesn't have a club for this, but I'm going to go ahead and stitch up Little House Needleworks Early American Series. So I bought the pattern for that. I bought the floss. I'm hoping the same floss gets used over and over, but you know, who knows? It's all Classic Colorworks. They had everything but the red that goes in there. They were out of it. Oops, don't look at the pattern. It is used brick. If I can't get a hold of used brick, because this is probably going to be the next thing I start. If I can't get a hold of used brick, I'm just going to substitute in Lancaster Red from Gast because I live in Lancaster County and I have it and I really actually like that shade of red. Other pieces of haul. This is something that I bought. This looks kind of messy. This is one of Trisha from 3L Threads. This is one of her bags. And I have been, can I get this the way I want it? I'm sorry about this, guys. I've been taking this bag to work with me every night this past week and stitching. And I'm going to unload the other bag and just show you. But yeah, like bag. You've seen her bags. They're fabulous. There's the bag. Love it. And I've been working on Luna. If I think about it, I will insert a picture of where she was the last time you saw her. She was a mania start. Sorry, the needle came off the needle minder. I didn't have very much done on her. I only stitched on her that one day at Mania. And this is where we are now. So all of these sections that you see in here, those are all beads. These are all beads in through here. So I have like the rest of her cape. I'm doing her skin over one because apparently I like to torture myself. This is being stitched on 32 count falling leaves from Hand Dyed Fabrics by Stephanie. The pattern is Luna by Nora Corbett. And she looks like so when she is done. So she's gorgeous. Every game I play, my boyfriend likes to game. Every game we play, my character's name is always Stella Luna. Not because of the book. I didn't even know there was a book. It's before my time, peeps. But, yeah, so when I saw this, I knew I had to have it, and I knew I had to stitch it. So when everybody else was on their Gigi, like, oh, I gotta stitch Gigi, I've gotta stitch Gigi, I was like, oh, no, I've gotta do Luna. So, yep, there's Luna. She's beautiful. Really enjoying her. I was gonna power through until I got her done, but... Oh, sorry. Another drink. We'll get there. But I just can't believe how pretty she is. And for one of the little girls, the smaller ones, she actually has quite a bit to her. She has a lot of beads. So that'll be fun. So that was my work project this past week or so. I'll pull her out again on the 13th for dark 13 stitching. She's gonna live in this bag because, yes, I love it. The next thing I worked on was on the 5th of March. This was my, what's it called? Ex Machina, mini Ex Machina from Heaven and Earth Design. I'll insert a picture of what this looks like here. If I think about it. And I didn't get much done. Almost 400 stitches. Not quite. And I only worked on it for a little bit that day. Using the parking method. Oh, the pumpkin on Luna was from Gina. And what do I have on this one? This is actually what this pattern looks like. So maybe I won't insert a picture there. Mini Ex Machina. And the other... Ooh. Other needle minder is a clockwork angel that came from Nifty Needle Nannies. I'm guessing that was inspired by, not the Mortal Instruments, the other one. You know, the woman who did the Mortal Instruments, Shadow Hunters, it's on TV, kind of butchering the series. What was the other one called? Infernal Devices from that series, which is kind of an offshoot of the Mortal Devices. And yeah, I'm gonna save my rant for last. I'll show you my other whip. Other whip. This is again in one of Trisha's bags. So I got two. And what's nice is you can see your project. See, there's my Coffee Quaker Sal, and I started that today. And this is just pretty pink. But I want to show you guys. I'm gonna unpack it and show you what all I have in here because this is what I take with me when I stitch at work. So here's my project. It is an 11 by 11 Q-snap. Here, I'll show you what I've gotten done. Not much. I just, like I said, I just started that this morning. So I got, first I drank the coffee and I started on the first motif. I wanted to finish it, but it was really beautiful outside today. So I was outside playing fetch with the dog until my allergies made me choke and then we came inside. It was really nice outside. This is on 28 count Jobelin in Vanilla Latte from Hand Dyed Fabrics by Stephanie. Stitching this for my dad. My dad loves coffee. I'm a tea drinker, as is my mother. And they did rechart this. She recharted it for people who drink tea and I believe diet soda. But I went ahead and I may stitch this again for tea and do it in shades of like green and cinnamons and stuff like that. But I'm just using the called for colors, and then my needle minders are both from Nifty Needle Nannies. It's a Frappuccino and Sally Deadly Nightshade. So anyway, that is an 11 by 11 Q-snap put together. You don't have to take it apart, which is really nice. And here is the pattern. And I know that that came from Stitch and Frog. And everybody is working on this, so I'm sure you guys have all seen it. So there's that. I have my, I got this at the Stitching Retreat in Hershey 2 years ago. But I think Leslie was selling these. They're just like a little portable art jar. Art, bleh, I can talk. Art jar without a jar. And it collapses, which is nice. I have my little Notions bag where I keep my styluses. Styli. I have no idea what the plural is. For when I stitch from my iPad, which is always ideally, but I can't when I'm at work because we're not allowed. I'm air quoting. Not allowed to use electronic devices at work. Except on break. And I don't stitch on my break. I meditate on my break. Because I need to. I got like 3 pairs of scissors in here. A bunch of... I mean, this thing's packed full. Oh, look. I have this. Anna. I have 3 pairs of scissors, a bunch of needles, my Snag Nabbits in there, batteries for my light, and yeah, so all the stuff. There's a Frogger in there, so that's in there. So that is jam-packed full. Here are my threads, and that came from 123 Stitch with the fabric that is still wrong. And then the way that I stitch when I have to stitch with a chart is just with a magnetic board. And this, I use this guide just to, I don't mark my patterns ever. Not my actual patterns. Sometimes I mark the very center and that is it. Everything else, I just kind of keep my guide and remember where I was. So that is it for my whips. I will, oops. Oh, and my lamp is in here too. I thought, there's more. But yeah, this is how much you can fit in these bags. I love my So Much to Love bags. But man, you can fit a lot in these. So that is a pair of reading glasses. I do wear glasses. And because I am so classy when I am at work, I put them on right over top of my prescription glasses because I'm classy like that. And then I have my little portable light. So all of that fits in this bag. How awesome is that? And this is her original quilted bag. And I just, excuse me as I stuff everything back in here. I just love these bags so much. All right, so now I'm going to do a rant about Stitching Bits and Bobs, like everybody else has been doing rants about Stitching Bits and Bobs. So, now I have my rant about Stitching Bits and Bobs. You know, they have good prices, and we all know that they have good prices, and that they have really, really, really shitty customer service. I've been very fortunate that they have answered emails from me a few times, mainly because there were billing questions. Like, a couple times I've had things where it looked like PayPal went through twice, and I wanted to make sure I wasn't billed twice. And you know how long it takes to get your stuff, and I didn't want it, I wanted the question answered, so they did actually answer me about that stuff. But this time my order, it didn't take the normal month. I think the quickest I ever got anything was 2 weeks, and I was shocked. But this time it was 10 weeks, at least, and it was right in the midst of, I know Danielle's already talked about it, so right in the midst of her order taking forever. And Heather, her order took forever. And like them, I have broken up with Stitching Bits and Bobs. I am done with them. There are too many other good shops out there who, you know what? You may pay a little more, but you get better customer service. Do I need, excuse me, do I need this stuff right away? No. If I did, I wouldn't order from them. But just no. It's no. Done. So what I bought from them, and these weren't the holdup. 2 patterns. First one is Ink Circles Dutch Beast. Wanted this for a while. It's adorable. Had to have it. They're the only ones that I could find anyway that currently had it. And I also got, again, I couldn't find this anywhere else, and I had been looking for it, got the smell of sulfur from Ink Circles. And this was our holdup right here. I ordered the silk pack, and they do have a good price on these silk packs for the Glen and Place mandalas. This is for Fudgy Mint Mousse. This guy apparently held up my order for 10 weeks. Are you kidding me? No. Just no. It couldn't have possibly taken 10 weeks to get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 14 skeins of silk. Just no. I don't believe it. But it's here now. I'm irritated. I really wanted to start it. Now it's just like, I don't, because it irritated me. So, I don't know. I've been trying to be more positive. I've felt like crap for a while. I've had a fiber flare for a while. I don't know if being sick put me into it or if the weather put me into it. I mean, we had tornado warnings in February. We had a blizzard in March. It poured and poured and poured for 2 days. Just the last couple of days, and now it's bright and sunny and beautiful. One day it's in the 30s, the next day it's in the 70s. You don't know how to dress. It's just been weird. And, you know, I'm trying to be more positive, and just things are really crappy right now. And there's nothing that anybody could even do other than win the lottery and give me a few million dollars so that I don't have to work anymore. And I can buy my own house with a room that I can customize to be my stitchy room. And people just leave me alone and let me stitch. That would make me very happy. One thing that does make me happy, and one thing I am really looking forward to, is that I am going to Austin. I am going to the Floss Tube Retreat. And I absolutely cannot wait to meet everyone. I'm so excited. I mean, I'm not one of the floss, and I say this like in air quotes because I know they don't think of themselves this way, but I'm not one of the Floss Tube royalty people. You know, I have a meager number of subscribers. I know I'm not one of the popular ones. I don't show my face unless you look at my little thumbnail. Then you can see my face. I don't show my face for those of you who may be new viewers. My ex is a stalker, and I had gotten rid of him and got him out of the state, and he has gotten through all of the barricades to let me know that he's back in the area. He's in the next county over. He's got no reason to be in Pennsylvania. He has no family here. He has no friends here. The only reason he is here is to try to make me miserable. He doesn't, but I just... if he finds this channel, he doesn't need to see me. And yeah, that's why I'm not on camera. So what else is going on with me? Not a lot. We're really busy at work. I think people are very nervous about what's going on with healthcare. From someone who works in healthcare, if you want my perspective on it, do changes need to be made? Absolutely. Is Obamacare broken? I don't know that broken is what it is. It certainly needs to be fixed at the very least. Repeal and replace terrifies me as a patient and as a caregiver. I work in outpatient testing. I do sleep studies. And when Obamacare came in, we were getting called off left and right because people either were unemployed and they couldn't afford their testing, they didn't have insurance, or if they had insurance, they suddenly couldn't afford their copays. And that wasn't just the sleep lab, that was outpatient testing in general. And at the time I was renting, and I blew through all of my vacation days because I couldn't afford to not get paid. My ex was not working. He hadn't worked in 4.5 years. And it was terrifying. You know, I was living paycheck to paycheck, and he wouldn't get off my sofa. So that was kind of my last straw. I finally got rid of him. My parents and I agreed that I would move back here. Their health hasn't been great. It allowed me to get out of debt, and it allowed me to create a savings, and it allowed me just a lot of freedom, which was wonderful and very generous of them. And, things have picked up, and we're very, very busy. And I think it's because people are scared. They don't know if they're going to have insurance next year. I don't see anything taking effect until 2018, but who knows? People are running to get testing. And what's going to happen in a year or two when these repeal and replace changes happen? Are people again going to be left without insurance? Are they going to be canceling their much needed outpatient testing because they can't afford it, which is heartbreaking when you're trying to care for people that they just can't come in because they don't have an insurance, or they can't afford their co-pays if they do. And that's one of the reasons I haven't bought a house. I'm scared. I don't want to go back to living paycheck to paycheck. I just stay here, and I pay rent, and I pay some of the bills, and I bank my money and cross my fingers because we don't know what's going to happen. All we can do is pray that they don't screw it up too badly. So I'm going to step down off my soapbox about that. It is Palm Sunday, so if you are part of the Christian faith who celebrates Easter and Palm Sunday, happy. Do you even say Happy Palm Sunday? I think you even say Happy Palm Sunday. But, we got palms at church, so that's always nice. And we're done making Easter eggs. We do that for a month every Saturday leading up to Easter as a fundraiser, which I think we spend more money. I don't think we make very much after all the expenses are donated and everything, but it's a yearly thing. So we're done making peanut butter eggs, which is awesome. And guess that's about it. I hope everybody's having a good weekend and having a good Sunday. I am going to try not to be so long. No promises. Life, it happens, and you never know what's going to get in your way. I'm hoping that things start to even out. I want to try to do Jessie Marie's birthday celebration thing that she's doing. I know I can't do it all. I was watching Emily's video, and it stresses me out, the switching every day, which is probably going to impact Stitch Mania for me too. So we'll see. I have to think about that. I may just try to pull out a few projects that I was going to work on anyway for Stitch Mania and just do it that way. But anyway, have a good day, and I will see you later. Bye bye.